皈依和呢，按理来讲应该有很多的皈依的一些需要，应该遵守的一些戒。但这个戒律呢，如果归纳起来的话，曾经，有一位印度的班指导叫阿底夏尊者，他呢，应该是72岁吧，大概在那个时候，就当时杜牧给他授记，就是说是没有去藏地的话，他可能严守，20年。但因为他为了度化藏地的众生呢，就是所以他来了，本来他可以活到这个92岁，但因为他的这个他来藏地弘法的原因呢，他可能只活了72岁。那么他整天的是讲那个皈依的功德。他在藏地，所有的弘法呢，都是天天讲皈依。很多人的烦恼就是说是这个天天给我们开皈依的法会，但是呢，后来就阿底夏尊者叫做是皈依上师。有些人诽谤说，就是他只会讲皈依三宝，其他什么都不会讲。有些弟子呢，就是说是别人就说你皈依弟子什么都不懂，那你应该换个口，就是讲个其他的。他说不用，我就讲皈依，就是所有的佛法当中皈依是最好的。别人说我是皈依上师的话，那对我是一个极大的赞叹。
So after we take refuge, we should follow or maintain some precepts or discipline. One of the Indian Pandita, Venerable Atisha, then when we talk about Atisha, there's a little bit story about him from his biography. He died when he was 72 years old. However, if he didn't go to Tibet, he can live until he can live till 92 years old. This was a prophecy given by the Dara to him before he was thinking he should go to Tibet or not. But then he decided, even though he knew that he will live less, there are 20 years he...
less for him to live.
Yeah, so you understand that. he still decided to go to Tibet to spread the Dharma. And when he was in Tibet, he taught taking refuge all the time. So people were talking about him, and they said, Atisha can only talk about taking refuge. So they call him Taking Refuge Lama, a kind of nickname for him. So his students, after his students find out this, his students told him, maybe you should teach something else, because we know you know a lot of things. Why you are always just teaching taking refuge? And then he said, I will not change my topic on taking refuge, because taking refuge is the most important thing in Buddhism. And when they call me Taking Refuge Lama, I think that is the best commendation that they gave to me.
因为这里也有一些佛教徒应该需要知道皈依戒，所以阿底夏尊者当时说有5条。第一条呢，说这个即使遇到生命危险呢，就是皈依三宝的人呢，不要这个放弃三宝。就这样的现象呢，我们人类历史上很多人都是就为了这个三宝啊，就是就即使遇到生命危险也不舍弃的，这是第一条。
So I think because there must be some Buddhists here, maybe you need to know the 5 points that Venerable Atisha gave about the precepts for taking refuge. And the first one is, even if your life is endangered, you should not abandon the 3 jewels. And this, you may find a lot of stories or examples or cases like that in the human history.
那么第二个，即使遇到重大的事情，也不改变一些方法。意思就是说呢，就是 不寻找其他的办法吧，就是即使遇到再大的事情，比如说别人就是说让你放弃这个佛教徒的身份，就可以给你获得一个很大的奖励啊，就是地位啊等等，这样的话呢就是也不会答应的，就这是第二条。
And so the second one is if you are in a very difficult time and if you are in trouble, besides relying on the three jewels, you should not seek other approaches to solve this problem. And even if people give you bribery or give you something very, very valuable for you to give up your faith in Buddhism, you should not do that.
第三条呢，就是说经常这个碎念三宝而不间断供养，就是作为一个佛教徒呢，就经常就是念这个有一个叫碎念三宝经啊，还有呢就是经常在佛堂里面就是做这个供养啊等等。
And the third one is we should always recollect the kindness or the merit of the three jewels. And there is a sutra called Constantly Recollecting the Three Jewels Sutra.And in that, it says we should not, we should always make offerings to the three jewels and recollecting the three jewels' merit. So the third one is we should not interrupt the continuity of making offerings to the three jewels.
第四条呢，就是自己皈依的基础上，就让别人也皈依，就像一些基督教一样的，就是让别人也经常。皈依啊，其实佛教徒呢，就是也有，就是，遇到一些有怨的这些人的话呢，也给他可以讲这个皈依的功德，让他自愿的，如果加入的话呢，也可以跟他就是推荐和，劝他们就是进入这个这种智慧的宗教。
And the fourth one is, We should not take refuge, we should not only ourselves take refuge, we should also tell others about the benefit of taking refuge in Buddhism and advise other people to take refuge in Buddhism. This is maybe similar to Christianity, what the priests, they go to places to ask people to become Christian. So when wewmeet people who have some karmic collection, a good collection, or fortunate people who are interested in Buddhism, we should tell them about Buddhism and recommend them or encourage them to become Buddhists.
第五条就是不管到哪里去，经常呢，就是这个顶礼，佛菩萨，我都经常，无论到哪里去的话，自己随身带着一些佛像。然后在宾馆里面也好，在寺院里面也好，然后就方便的时候呢，就是做顶礼。所以作为一个佛教徒呢，应该就是去处有一些佛像呢，也可以顶礼，就你去的地方。然后自己呢，就是如果随身带着，也是礼佛是很重要的一件事情。
And the fifth one is, wherever you go, if you see Buddha statues, you should make a prostration, pay homage. And for this one, you can do the prostration in front of the Buddha statues in the place where you are going, like in the temples or monasteries. And also, when you travel, you can carry some small Buddha statue with you. Then in your hotel room, you can put it on the desk or on the table. Then you can make prostration to the Buddha.